Very good evening, everyone. My name is Shubham Singhania, and I'm your mentor for UGC NET Paper 1, Paper 2 Commerce and Management. So in our last video, we have talked about that what should you choose between a PhD as well as a teaching job. So in continuation with our series of videos for our UGC NET students, in this particular video, I'm going to talk about what is the difference between a full-time PhD as well as a part-time PhD. So ye ek basic question hai jo students ke dimag mein rehta hai, and they are confused between the differences and what are the advantages of doing a full-time PhD or a part-time PhD. So in this video, I am going to clarify the differences, and at last I'm also going to tell you that which of these is better or suitable for what kind of students. So let's get started. So the first and the foremost difference between a full-time PhD and a part-time PhD is that a full-time PhD scholar has to regularly go to a college. That means if you have joined a PhD at some institute as a full-time scholar, to aapko 5 din week mein ya fir aap 6 din bhi kuch kuch institutes mein aapko regularly college jana padega. You will have to attend your classes, you will have to discuss your research work with your supervisor. Whereas if you are working as a part-time PhD scholar in any institute, to probably aapko month mein ek baar jana padega ya kai situations mein 3 mahine mein bhi ek baar jana padta hai, and you just go there, discuss your research work with your supervisor and then come back. So this is the first and the foremost difference, and there would be some variations with respect to institute. The second major difference between a full-time PhD and a part-time PhD is that you get your GRF scholarship only if you are pursuing your full-time PhD. So if you are part-time PhD, then you can't claim from UGC. Sakte hain. So that is the second major difference. And the third major difference is that if you're doing a full-time PhD, you cannot take a full-time employment, whether it be a teaching or a corporate job. So aap koi bhi job nahi le sakte hain because you are availing the junior research fellowship from UGC. Whereas if you're doing a part-time PhD, in that case, you would not be getting any kind of scholarship, and you can do your full-time employment in any institute, whether it be a teaching institute or be it a corporate job. Also, यहाँ पे मैं एक important चीज़ बताना चाहूँगा that in many of the institutes they have put up a condition, एक condition रख देते हैं वो that you can only enroll for a part-time PhD if you are working full-time in a government institute. So for that matter, you will have to check the conditions for each and every institute where you are specifying. Now the question that might be in your mind is then which of these is better, because both of them are ultimately giving you a PhD degree only. So here I would like to tell you one more thing, that if you have completed your master's right now and you think that you are very inclined towards research, you have a lot of interest into research and you want to pursue research in your future life also apart from teaching. In that circumstance, it's better that you explore a full-time PhD, because aapko ek 3-4 saal ka time mil jayega where you will get to know all the nitty-gritties and the complexities of research, and in the long run you will have the options of getting into research field also apart from your teaching job. Whereas if you have completed your master's and you think that teaching is something where you're inclined, you're passionate about only teaching, and research is only going to be a kind of a degree for you just scale up your ladder in the teaching profession, then in those circumstances, what you should do, you should be finding a job, whether it be in a private institution or in any other institution. And after a few years, when you feel that now it's the time you have gained some kind of experience of teaching, you can probably enroll for a part-time PhD. And in those circumstances, the institutions would also be very likely to select you based on your experience. So this is the major difference, and accordingly, based on your requirements, you can choose to go for a full-time PhD or a part-time PhD. Now, one more aspect that is very crucial here is that it is but obvious that if you are doing a part-time PhD, you will not be able to focus much on your research because of your job, because of your other assignments. And therefore, it is very natural that the time that is being taken by scholars in the normal circumstances is usually more than 5 years. So, if you do full-time PhD, so the minimum time is 3 years, which maximum goes out to be 5 years. But if you are a part-time scholar, then usually your time is 5 years more. So, accordingly, you can take a decision and choose wisely. So that was all about this video. If you think that you have got to know something new, you have learned something new, you have found something informative in this video, please hit the like button. And if you are coming here for the very first time, do subscribe to our channel. Thank you and have a nice day.